Hello and welcome back to another tutorial. My name is Mike Davies. Yes, I'm switching up the intro because my mouth is getting super tired of saying the same thing at the beginning of every video. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to use GIMP's non-destructive crop tool feature. This is found in GIMP version 2.10.20, which is the latest version of GIMP and the version I'll be using for today's tutorial. Before I get into that, check out my website at daviesmediadesign.com. As always, I have tons of GIMP, Inkscape, and Darktable tutorials on here. You can get more with a premium membership, and I have tons of free software help articles, so definitely check that out. You can enroll in my GIMP 2.10 Masterclass from beginner to pro photo editing on Udemy. You can enroll in any of my Skillshare classes by visiting gimpschool.com. And as I mentioned, you can get more with a premium membership to Davies Media Design, and I'll include a link to this as well as all the relevant links from this tutorial in the description of the video. I'll be using this photo for today's tutorial. It is a free stock photo from Unsplash. You can click to download this for free. So the GIMP team introduced the non-destructive feature or non-destructive option to the crop tool with the release of GIMP 2.10.20. For those of you who are not aware, the crop tool is used to essentially change the size or aspect ratio of an image or a layer. It doesn't change the size like the scale tool does by scaling it up or down. It just changes the size by getting rid of excess pixels outside of the crop area. So you can access this tool by hitting Shift C on your keyboard. That's going to bring up the crop tool. And here below, you can see the tool options for this tool. And the second option is a checkbox labeled Delete Cropped Pixels. So when this is checked like it is right now, that means that all of the pixels outside of your crop area are going to be deleted much like they were prior to this tool's new feature being added. So in other words, this is the destructive feature. And let me come down here and uncheck the fixed box. So right now, the only option that is checked is Delete Cropped Pixels. If I click and drag my mouse, that's going to draw my crop area. And of course, I could change the size of my crop area after the fact by hovering my mouse over any of the edges here or the corners, and then just click and drag. So that will adjust the crop area. So with this option checked, if I click inside the crop area, you'll see everything outside that area will be deleted now. So this is the new image canvas. Let me hit Control Z to back up. If I uncheck this option, this is going to be the new behavior. If I click and drag my mouse, and then I click inside to crop this, now you'll see that our image is cropped, so the canvas size has changed. However, everything outside of the original image layer is still there. So you can see that the layer boundaries are still here, and I do have an entire tutorial dedicated to layers, and I also include the layer mask on my channel, so definitely check that out if you want to learn more about layers. So the original image boundary is still there, and this has a variety of uses. So for example, if I hit the M key on my keyboard, that's going to grab my move tool. And essentially, I can now use my canvas as something like a frame, and I can adjust the positioning here of this layer. And because those original pixels are still there, as long as I keep the layer boundary here outside of the image boundary, we can have any of these pixels be inside of our canvas. So there you can see I've changed the position here of this. The other use for this, if I hold Control and use my mouse wheel to zoom out, is I can actually restore the area that I cropped out. So if I go to Image, Fit Canvas to Layers, that's going to change my canvas size back to the size of the layer here that we kept. So now this has essentially restored our image, and that's what makes this non-destructive. I do want to note some funky behavior when it comes to this new feature. So this actually doesn't work when you turn on cropping only the layer. Let me demonstrate what I mean. So if I come over to this tab, I have a composition I've made here beforehand, and I have three images here. So if I hit Shift C to bring up my crop tool, I don't have the delete cropped pixels turned on. I will turn on the current layer only option. And what this option is going to do is it's only going to crop pixels from the current layer I have selected. So in that case, it's going to be the top layer, which is this image right here. So now let's say I just crop this layer here, like so. And then I click inside to crop it. You'll notice that even though the delete cropped pixels is unchecked, it's going to still delete all of the pixels outside of that layer boundary. So this non-destructive feature doesn't necessarily work with individual layers. However, if I come over here, uncheck current layer only, and I draw my crop area. So now we're cropping all three layers on here and the background layer. So let's just draw this quickly. Now, if I click inside that area and I click on all the layers, you could see that all of the pixels from all of these layers is kept. And I can always come here with the move tool and I can just reposition these, and you'll see that all of those original pixels are kept. So this does act as a frame like it did before. So that's it for the brand new non-destructive cropping feature found in the crop tool in GIMP 2.10.20 or newer. If you want to learn everything there is to know about the crop tool, I recommend checking out my GIMP 2.10 masterclass on Udemy. You can also access those premium lectures by becoming a DMD premium member on my website. But that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully you liked it. If you did, you could check out my YouTube channel at youtube.com/DaviesMediaDesign. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon to be notified each time I have a brand new tutorial. You can also check out any of the links to my resources in the description of the video. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.